the Wizards had to do this, much like they had to sign Bradley Beal to the max deal. They couldn't let a guy they drafted number three overall, who's developed, who was shooting 45% from three-point land at one point, leading the NBA last season. You can't just let a player like that walk, especially if you can't use that money on somebody else. That money was basically earmarked for Otto. You had to spend it.
Yeah, and this happens a lot, and it goes back way further than even Bradley Beal. I mean, you can go all the way back to Rod Strickland when he played here. And Abe Pollin was basically, I mean, these owners, it gets to a situation where you're damned if you do and you're damned if you don't. And for Rod, they had to re-sign him, I want like $10 million or something like that. And they just couldn't let him go. And that becomes the situation with a lot of these players. Now, in the case of the Wizards, right, they don't want to let him go. The way Ernie Grunfeld looks at this thing, and Ted as well, they've got a terrific young core of really good players. I mean, Beal and Wall are so good, it's ridiculous, and they're so young. Even John, who's, you know, obviously now going into his, what, eighth year in the league or whatever, he's still young, and Otto Porter is very young. So that's the core of this team. And who knows what will happen this year. They should challenge once again for the Eastern Conference. We'll see if that happens. But if not, maybe you look to the year after that, and they're still young, and they're still good, and they're still acquiring pieces. They're trying to bolster that bench a little bit. They got three guys that hopefully will be better than some of the guys they had before, save for maybe Bogdanovich. So, yeah. You got to re-sign him. He's a good player. He's a local guy in terms of college, and he's a great kid. And you love the way he plays. I love the way he plays, and I'm a player.
John Wall every night. If you had to, you know, offer up one thing that he could work on this summer to develop, what do you think that one thing should be?
Well, look, I'm not an expert, and far be it from me to offer advice to John Wall or any other player in the NBA, but as an observer, what I would do, I would do three things. First and foremost, and I've said this for the last couple of years, work on that floater in the lane. Become consistent at making that shot like Westbrook and like Irving, because he gets in the lane, he gets by people, and he's getting better at it. But it's a shot that's very hard to you know, duplicate, replicate, hard to make. Phil talks about it all the time. When you get in the lane like that, he's either going to pass the ball off or shoot, hope to get fouled, and get to the line. But if you can become consistent at that floater, because that's where he makes his living once he penetrates and gets in that lane, that's what I would work on. The other two things would be, A, defense. And John's a good defensive player when he wants to be. But too many times he'll reach around from behind and try to knock the ball away from guys. And, you know, that can be disastrous in the NBA. If you don't get the ball or you hit somebody, then they're going to beat you. And he's so quick with his feet that he can play that kind of defense. And the third thing would be free throw shooting, which he's gotten much better at. He was making clutch shots. His percentage went up this year. And so I think he's worked on that. And obviously continue to work on the outside shot. But that floater, to me, is where he's going to become unstoppable. Yeah, I mean, it takes a lot to get to the NBA Finals. Remember, there are 28 teams that don't get to the NBA Finals.
Right.
There are always, I mean, you just have to understand that it's, you know, I hear these baseball players talk about it all the time. Ryan Zimmerman said the other day, it's hard to win games. I mean, it's just hard. It's hard to get to the Eastern Conference Finals. The Wizards were one win away from the Eastern Conference Finals. They were one win away from being the two best teams in the NBA in the Eastern Conference along with Cleveland. So it's close. It's not that far off, and I know that's how Ernie feels about this. Now, I know there are detractors and critics and what have you, but he's got to have this core with these players. These are the young players that they got to build around and eventually get to that spot. But I mean, again, only two teams get to the finals, and the rest of the league is shaking their heads saying, well, what do we need? What do we need? And of course, Boston looks like they're just outrageous and monstrous and everything else. So they're getting everything they need, and some teams do and some teams don't, but you just got to do it piece by piece and hope that you can get over that hump at some point. But again, only two teams do.
Buck, the backup point guard spot's been a revolving door of late. Guys like Eric Maynor, Andre Miller, Brandon Jennings. Is Tim Frazier a more stable option at that position at this point?
Well, we will see. He's a young player, and he's been a backup, so he's not what you would call an impact player. But We were disappointed in what Trey Burke brought last year, especially after Ramon Sessions the year before, who I thought was a very good backup to John Wall. And I was disappointed in Trey because he showed signs to me in different games that he was a really good player, but it just never manifested itself. Hopefully this kid will be better. He'll be more productive. He'll be able to give the team what they need, but we don't know that yet, and we're going to just have to wait and see on that and hope that one of these guys, him or maybe Jody Meeks, can have a great comeback and be good like he was a few years ago. Mike Scott, you know, these guys hopefully will help in a better way than the bench helped last year, and that's really what they have to rely on at this point because the bench just – you know, wasn't very good last year, save for a couple of guys. And I love Jason Smith. I think he's awesome. I'm glad he's there. So we'll see how these other guys do, and hopefully Frazier will be decent.